Hello and welcome to the Noble Leaders Cup. I'm Kjotleik. This is the first qualifying round game between Logan and Johan de Witt. Logan is expansive and protective, and the Iroquois start with fishing and the wheel. Johan de Witt is financial and organized, and Netherlands start with fishing and agriculture. This is the starting position of Logan. Let's get the resource bubbles on for a moment. Riverside, there is silk, we see ivory down here, there is wheat and some crabs up here, there is aluminum for later and some cows over here. It starts all the way here in the north of the starting continent. On the southern part we have the starting position of Johan de Witt Riverside with copper and with stone and cows and some oases in the desert up here. So let's see who can go through this time. Here we are, ready to start the game, and off we go. Logan versus Johan de Witt in the first qualifying round of the Noble Leaders Cup. One city each. Johan de Witt is pleased with Logan already. And we see here two cities first for Logan. He settles down there, two cities for both of them. And now Johan de Witt is cautious. They are in different religions, with Johan de Witt in Buddhism and Logan in Hinduism. Four cities to three, Logan first to four cities. Building up, expanding up in the north. Johan de Witt has his place down in the south. 6-3 city count for Logan now, 6-4 immediately after that. But he had 6-3 for a moment there, even though he's equal in strength with Johan. Johan de Witt is getting construction and then some other stuff. 9-5 for Logan now, and now we have touching borders for the two empires as well. Turn 168 now. 9-6. 10-6 as we see. Logan is very good at expansion. He has come all the way down to the Netherlands, to Johan de Witt. 10-7 is the count now. Johan de Witt is getting engineering while Logan is on music. 10-8 as Johan de Witt is building up his cities as well. 11-8. Still cautious. 11-9 now. And they are almost out of room for expansion, at least on the southern part of the starting continent. We see Logan with 12-9 now. Johan de Witt is wise enough to try to go for astronomy here, trying to go into the new world. 14-10, Logan has the advantage. He's going for guilds and Johan is going education. They are at turn 225. 14-10, let's see how fast Johan de Witt can expand into the new world. If he can send his settlers out to build cities there. 14-10 still. Logan getting his engineering, Johan de Witt on music. Logan now on astronomy. 14-10. Will Johan de Witt get cities up in the new world before Logan can compete with him? It looks like he's about to settle a couple. Yes, he did. If you see all the way to the west and all the way to the east, you see a couple of cities on the same continent. 14-12 now. Johan de Witt with 12 cities. Logan 0.9 the strength. And Logan also is capable of sending his settlers out now. Let's see who can get there first. He settles an island up in the northwest, Logan, for 15-12 in city counts. And there it is, over in the east, the first Iroquois city in the east. He's going for gunpowder next, 17-15 now, as Johan de Witt is expanding in the new world as well, 18-15 now. We see Logan's cities up there in the northeast as well on that continent. No Netherlands cities on that exact continent, but he's taking the other continents. 18-15, equal in strength. A little bit more score for Logan, and a little few more cities. Going military science now, we are at turn 293. Johan de Witt is still pleased with Logan though. 18-19 for Logan. Johan de Witt on 16. And now Logan goes for constitution next. Johan de Witt is trying to reach scientific method. 20-18 as Johan de Witt is settling a few cities down on the southern part of that same continent as Logan has taken up in the north in the east, as you can see. 21-18. We do have the privateers on the scene, so they are going to be a nuisance. 22-, Logan now. 18-, Johan de Witt. Logan still has a few cities advantage. getting his corporation up while Johan de Witt is going for replaceable parts 22 to 19, and now Johan de Witt is even friendly, going steam power next to Johan de Witt. Logan is on military tradition, 22 cities to 20, and with friendly relations, this could be down to who builds the Apostolic Palace as well, of course. 23 to 20 is the city count, but the privateers are still on the scene. Logan 1.1 times the strength of Johan de Witt. Johan going for steel. 26 cities to 20 now. Logan is expanding really good. Up to 26 cities, going scientific method next. Johan de Witt getting railroads. Seems to be stuck on 20 cities now, Johan de Witt, for the moment. 26 to 20, Logan also on steel, going biology, but Logan is going culture. As he started teching biology, Logan has started running the cultural slider. It's at 70%, gaining 2,500 culture per turn. So this is important. Johan de Witt, you must see the danger of this. We are at turn 353, 354. It is early enough that Logan, if he can be allowed to continue this, he will for sure win a cultural victory. Johan de Witt needs to stop that. He needs to attack, but he is pleased with Logan, which means that he probably will not. Oh, this game, Logan, you are weaker than Johan de Witt. Johan de Witt is getting rifling, but you have more cities and you have more score. 26 to 20 is the city count. Logan is down to 0.7, the strength of Johan de Witt. And Johan de Witt falls down to cautious now. And it should be said that Johan de Witt must be attacking now in order to stop Logan from winning a cultural victory. And I am not so sure that is going to be enough either, because if Logan can defend, but now Logan is down to 0.5 the strength of Johan de Witt, which means that Johan must be building up his units. Logan is down to 0.5 the strength. Will Johan de Witt attack early enough to stop Logan's cultural victory attempt? 26 to 20, 26 to 21 is the city count now. Johan de Witt still hasn't attacked. There is the attack. Now we have the war. Logan down to 0.4, the strength of Johan de Witt. He's still going for culture. He's still trying to win culture. 26 to 22 is the city count. Johan de Witt is going for industrialism. 23 to 25, he took a city off of Logan now. And Logan still going culture. How close is Logan to his third cultural cities? I haven't even seen one legendary city now for Logan. But that doesn't mean that he doesn't have it, it just means I may have missed it. 24 cities each, Johan de Witt. 25 to 23, Logan down to 23 cities, Logan down to 22 cities. Johan de Witt is attacking and taking cities very fast now. Rapid expansion for Johan de Witt, but Logan is still on his cultural attempt with 60% on the slider, gaining 3,000 culture per turn. 21 cities left for Logan now. Johan de Witt is taking them rapidly, but is it fast enough? Will he take one of the three cultural cities before it is too late? Johan de Witt, he is fighting for his victory here, trying to stop Logan from winning a cultural victory. He did what he needed to do. He did attack, but is he going to make it fast enough? 20 cities left for Logan. Logan still on a cultural slider, turn 402, 19 cities left for Logan. Logan is still on the cultural slider. 19 cities left. Johan de Witt, are you going to be able to win domination before Logan can win culture? 31, 18 cities left for Logan now, 32 to 18. Logan is down to 18 cities, but he's still running the cultural slider, as you can see up on the left corner of the screen. Turn 409. And I don't know how close Logan's third cultural city is to reaching legendary culture. 18 cities left though for Logan. And Johan de Witt, 33 cities to 18. Still cultural slider for Logan. Logan is doing what he can, and he's trying to win culture. Now he's down to 16 cities suddenly. Johan de Witt with 35, Logan with 16. And Logan is still on the cultural attempt. He's running the slider, gaining 2,200 culture per turn. At the moment, 16 cities left for Logan. Sorry about that. Logan down to 15 cities now. 14 cities now. Johan de Witt, how close are you to domination? How? And now Johan, no, Logan has stopped going culture. Logan has stopped going culture. He must have lost one of his cultural city cities he's using all his all his commerce on money and back to science, but it's down to 12 cities. It was a failed cultural attempt by Logan and Johan de Witt. He took advantage of the situation, building up units, and he's going to win domination now. We are at turn 426. 42 to 10, Logan is down to 10 cities, Johan de Witt must be close to domination. This was important. I have seen leaders failing to realize that their opponent is trying to go for a cultural victory and not attacking in time, but Johan de Witt did attack in time. He stopped Logan's cultural attempt, and now Logan is down to 10 cities and Johan de Witt is going to win domination, and there is the confirmation. Turn 433, 2013 AD, Johan de Witt has won the domination victory. Congratulations. Logan had started to go for a cultural victory by running the slider. Johan de Witt discovered that and attacked in 1961, turn 381, winning 16-0 in city captures, ending the war in 52 turns, winning domination in 2013, turn 433. That is a very efficient war. It means that it took a city every 3.25 turns, which is very effective, I think, I'd like to say. Let's go take a look then at the stats and the graphs and stuff. Exit here, and here we see Logan is the blue, and here he, lost it. And Johan de Witt is, of course, the orange. This is the score. This is the GNP. This is the production. This is the food. Sorry. Coughing again. Power, culture, and espionage. So let's go to the demographics then and see Logan's numbers to the left. We see Johan de Witt to the right, and he has good some good numbers here. top 6 cities are Wonderstone. Let's go to the bottom and see that there were 3 wonders in the BC era, Oracle, Stonehenge and the Great Wall. And we see Logan has the number 1 city, Johan de Witt has the number 2 city, then Logan has the 3rd and the 4th and the 5th and the 6th. So Johan de Witt has the number 2 city and Logan has the rest. Statistics then, Logan built 26 cities, 4 legions, 2 golden ages, currently on 17 towns, 10 mines, 8 windmills. He built a total of 28 granaries, 24 lighthouses, 18 harbors, down to 4 Taoist pagodas, page down. 1 Christian cathedral at the bottom there, page down again, and we see the Kong Miao as the last building on the list. Sorry. Current units then for Logan 18 Mohawk Archers, 8 12 grenadiers, 9 workers, down to 1 galleon. He did train a total of 64 Mohawk Archers, 37 Muslim and 36 Jewish missionaries, down to 6 Buddhist missionaries, page down. And we see 1 great general at the bottom of the list of units trained. Kills 3 cavalry frigates and infantry, down to 1 artillery, and the losses were 33 grenadiers, 29 Mohawk archers, 27 cuirassiers, down to 1 in the missionary. Let's go take a look at Johan de Witt's numbers then first. 26 cities built, 3 legions, 2 golden ages, currently on 73 windmills, 49 towns, 38 forest preserves. He did build a total of 26 granaries, 25 factories and barracks, 4 Buddhist temples we see there, page down, and we see a hermitage at the bottom of the next page, so page down again. And Angkor Wat is the last building built by Johan de Witt. We see it at the bottom there. Current units then, 94 infantry, 40 tanks, 37 workers, down to 1 cannon. He did train a total of 42 tanks, 35 workers, 33 marines, down to 4 crossbowmen, page down. And we see 1 spearman at the bottom of the list of units trained. The kills, 33 grenadiers, 29 Mohawk archers, 27 cuirassiers, down to 1 Jewish missionary, and the losses, 3 cavalry, frigates, infantry, and down to 1 grenadier. Congratulations, Johan de Witt. Let's go take a look at the victory condition screen. Here are the numbers. We see Johan de Witt on 74% of the land area and 79% of the world population, winning domination. These cities were probably not so 2 of the 3 cultural cities for Logan. Maybe Hochelaga was one, but I'm not so sure that one was either. Johan de Witt did build 4 casings before he did win the game, and also the Apostolic Palace. Let's go take a look at the cities. Logan has 10 of them left. Here they are, sort by population. Hochelaga 16, Kanienke 14, and Naterund also 14. They are happy, but they are very unhealthy. There is decentish to low food, and yeah, they are shrinking in a few turns. Commerce is not too good. Production is abysmal, as you can see. So let's not see it anymore. Let's just go and take a look at Johan de Witt's cities instead, because that is a lot better. I think he has 42 on them. Johan de Witt, 42 cities, sort by population, make sure we are at the top. And here we see Kampen, Pop 20, Nijmegen, Deventer 18, and you can see some of them are unhappy, but they are in general healthy. They have decent-ish food, with the exception of a newly captured city, Ono Duwaga, I see. I think it is newly captured at the very least. We see base commerce in some cities are decent, too good. See, the production is reasonably good, of course not in every city, but in a lot of them. 131 in Horn, 102 in Enkhuizen, so there are a few cities that are good. Eindhoven, Pop 9 is the bottom city on page 1, let's go to the bottom. 9 Eindhoven, and Dordrecht is the first city on page 2, and you can just pause the video if you want to take a look at these numbers. Congratulations then, Johan de Witt, winning domination 2013, turn 433. tomorrow there is also one cup game following the two league games. That is the game between Ludwig the First and Satur. I hope to see you back tomorrow then. I am Kjotleik. This has been the Noble Leaders Cup. Goodbye for today.